Welcome back to PSL Living. I'm Sarah Prohaska with the City of Port St. Lucie. I am pleased to welcome John from Elite Electric and Air. He is another one of our wonderful Hurricane Expo sponsors who has agreed to come on today at this emergency preparedness themed show we have today. So I really want to thank John for coming on with us today.
Thank you, sir. It's a pleasure to be here.
No problem. So Elite Electric and Air, I'm saying that correctly, right?
Yes.
Okay. How long have you been in business in Port St. Lucie?
30 years.
Wow. Okay. Family owned?
Yes.
Yeah. And you told me you've lived here since you were 8 years old.
Yes, ma'am.
That is rare for Port St. Lucie. So you've really watched the city change and grow over the years.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And so you and your wife run the business?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And what exactly do you do?
So the business itself?
The business itself, yes.
So we do electrical and air conditioning. Mm-hmm. We do generators, anything that pertains to electrical.
Okay.
Focusing on residential service repair and replacement.
Okay. Wonderful. Wonderful. Then I know, do you notice an upswing in business as the hurricane season approaches, as people are getting prepared?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Definitely with generators and whether it be portable or standby generators.
What is an important thing to remember with generators? I know people buy them after a storm and then they sit in their garage for a year. They don't touch them, they don't look at them. What are some of the things they should be doing throughout the year to maintain them so when a storm comes, it'll turn on?
So that's in reference to a portable generator?
To a portable generator, yes.
Yes. So just the general maintenance, just like it was a lawnmower, mm-hmm. you would want to start it up certainly every month or every other month, and keep it just generally maintained.
Okay.
So that's part of it. With the portable generators, some folks, they use just extension cords, so to check to make sure they have good extension cords and stuff of that nature.
Okay.
Unless it was tied into the house.
Yeah.
And then it should be tied into the house properly.
Probably with an electrician and done correctly, right?
Done correctly with a manual transfer switch or an interlock kit is what we would call it.
Okay, wonderful. Have you seen a lot more people since? We've had a couple storms. We had Hurricane Matthew, Hurricane Irma. Have you seen more people interested in those generators, the permanent generators for their homes?
Absolutely. Uh-huh. There's been a big, I don't want to say, like an influx of calls for people. The attitude has changed a little bit with the with the consumers and the community since the last storm, for sure. Just everybody, electrical is becoming more of that necessity.
Yes, people do not like to go without power for a week or even a few days. It's very inconvenient now. That's right.
They want to have water. They want to have their power. They want to be able to charge their cell phones.
Exactly. So even a portable generator can help you get your, keep a refrigerator plugged in so your food doesn't go bad and you can charge your phones and you can run usually a TV or something, but yeah.
That is correct.
At least have the little conveniences that we're used to in the aftermath of a storm. Because sometimes, we don't know how big, if we get hit with a huge one, it could be
devastating
in weeks before power comes back on. So
that's correct.
These are very important things to consumers now.
Florida Power and Light's been doing a good job replacing upgrading stuff.
So. Yeah, I do have to give FPL a plug because they've hardened a lot of their infrastructure, and it is compared to Francis and Jean, which I was around for in 2004. That was a very different experience to Irma, so as far as power outages in Port St. Lucie. So it's definitely made major improvements, I think.
I think FP&L has a fantastic partnership with the city, and we're excited that we're moving forward and we're really growing together as a city, and we have these local businesses and residents who have been here for as long as we've been around, and it's just fantastic to come out to the expo. Now, you've been doing this much longer than I have as far as attendance to the expo. I know that you said that you've been there from the beginning. Can you tell us and residents who are watching today a little bit about what you've seen from the expo in the past and why it's important for them to come out?
Sure. So we were talking a little bit ago about the first expo. That was like 12 years ago, is that correct?
Yeah.
So that was held right across the the street.
Yeah, the community center.
The community center. So at that time, there was a fair amount of folks that came out, and it's all about the safety and being prepared for just about anything that could happen. So I believe that the majority of the vendors and the majority of the businesses that are there at the Expo are there just to help say, hey, these are the things that we do to help keep you safe and in line and comfortable if there is a storm itself.
Yeah, there's we mentioned before, there's typically like 1,500 residents who come out and walk through, and they have the opportunity to speak with these exhibitors and meet with all of the agencies and really get that opportunity for that one-stop shop to go and visit with everybody that that could be of assistance.
That is correct, and I think the amount of folks, businesses, and community services that are coming to the events are more and more every single year.
Yep.
And I think you said that we're about ready to outgrow the Civic Center now.
You mentioned the community center 12 years ago.
Yep.
We have since jumped to the Port St. Lucie Civic Center, and we just see such a tremendous amount of residents come out. We're so happy to see that preparedness is really a focus for them when hurricane season is coming our way. And I think that having that preparedness and that sense of need to have safety for their homes and their families and their businesses, it's really great to see. And speaking of safety too, I know specifically with generators, one of the things that we try to push each year is for residents to really understand what generator safety is about, specific for portable generators and not running in their closed garages and things like that. So there's all kinds of great tips for residents to not just prepare, but learn how to prepare specific to their families and for their homes.
Right. I mean, certainly with the portable generators, the exhaust fumes are one of the bigger issues with them, and you got to be conscious of where they locate those generators and keep them far enough away from the home. It's no different than a standby generator. You want to keep the fumes away from windows, away from open doors, and stuff of that nature.
That's why we're so excited to have you on board as a sponsor this year with Elite Electric and Air, and we can really push residents to you and say, hey, he's a great contact. Make sure you go see John at the Hurricane Expo. They can really steer you in the right direction, and they're a trustworthy business. They're here. They've been here. They're staying.
Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, that's one of our logos. We are always here for you.
There you go.
Perfect. Well, you are here for us at the Hurricane Expo, so we really appreciate that.
Yep.
And I really want to thank you for coming on. Christina, before we head out, is there anyone else? I know we will have another special guest at the Expo this year.
Congressman Brian Mast is coming out and really showing his support. He'll be able to speak to residents a bit while he's there. Mm-hmm. We're just really excited to have him on board and show that level of support and really just talk to some of the residents that are out there and have a chance to show his opinion. And
and it's a great chance for residents to speak to him if they have emergency questions. One of our congressmen, our national congressman, it's a good chance to have a little bit of access to him.
Certainly a wealth of knowledge to be out there. And I just wanted to say again, thank you to all of our sponsors and for all the participation that we're having. The Expo is going to be on Saturday, June 2nd at the Port St. Lucie Civic Center.
Yes.
It's from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. And then if you're interested in participating in the Skywarn course, that is going to be pre-registration specifically, and that is from 9 to 11.
Yes.
We'll make sure to have all this on the city's website, citypsl.com.
Yes.
And if there's any questions that anyone has, they can contact us through the website.
Exactly. So, yeah, definitely make sure to check out citypsl.com. We should have it right there on the homepage, a whole section for Hurricane Expo and everything you need to get prepared, but basically you just need to show up.
That's all you need to do. Free event, and we can see awesome exhibitors and everyone who's out there, and have fun in the hurricane simulator. And, and
I'm excited.
Get some raffle prizes and a T-shirt, all of that. Thank you so much for coming out.
Can I be the first?
You could be the first.
There you go. You got to save a spot now.
Thank you, John, for coming out.
My pleasure.
All right, thank you so much, John. I really appreciate you coming on. Thank you, Christina, for all your information that you've shared with us throughout the show today, and we will see both of you at the Hurricane Expo, and we hope to see lots of residents out there with us. All right, and thank you so much for joining us on this episode of PSL Living. Once again, check the website for any information regarding Hurricane Expo. And we appreciate all our guests for being here today. Thank you.